Well, and very good, I tell you that. That was one of your picks. What was the rest of the plan?
So basically, to ban almost every mid laner we hate to play against. So Ziggs is just a must ban for us because we just hate to play it against it and it's super annoying. Kaylee, of course, I don't know, not much to say. And what was our last ban? Oh, it was actually, they banned Kassadin. We didn't expect them actually to ban Kassadin. Our plan was to ban Kassadin. And yeah, the Karthus ban was just because people banned yesterday Karthus versus him. So we just banned it.
What about the Yasuo pick then? Because it's often been banned against Froggen, but we haven't actually seen him play it. What do you think when he actually locked it in? And also despite the fact there was no knock-ups.
So we didn't even thought too much about Yasuo. Like we completely maybe forgot about him because for us, he isn't something special anymore. Like they didn't have any knock-up to follow him up. They just played him as split push and I was just at some point so fed that I just could 1v1 him easily. So we didn't have a concrete plan versus him or something. They just picked it and we just tried to counter it as much as we can.
Tell me about that one versus one moment when Froggen was going for the inhibitor once again. He likes to do that.
So, we were just pushing and we saw Yasuo. Like, I was already telling, if he comes, I will TP. So he came and I was like, oh. And I didn't have anything up. Like, I had maybe I had only my flash up, I think. So I was actually worried a bit that I won't beat him. But we just fought. And then I even misclicked my E. So I wanted to do it behind him, but he jumped at this moment. And I don't know how my auto attack hit him and killed him. So my heart was just beating really hard. And I was like, just so happy that it didn't turn out the other way.
Well, okay. About the 1v1s, though, early in the lane versus Renekton, you had some issues. Talk me through the matchup of Trundle versus Renekton.
So the matchup is normally early. The favorite is always Renekton. This time, actually, I got kind of surprised from the Darren's Blade. It was really an aggressive stage of the early. And he just pushed me in. And I kind of don't like to last it at the turret with Trundle. It's a bit hard when a Renekton with Darren's Blade stands there and tarries you with the Q. It's a lot of damage. So the early was really hard for me. But after the first gank, it just went easier.
And then I'd actually like to know more general top lane picks, because we've seen Shen, Irelia, a lot of new things, Jax, we had the Aatrox. What do you think about all these new champion picks, and which one do you actually prefer the most?
I prefer the assassins most, like Jax, Irelia, like they were always my favorites already from Season 2. So I would love to see that meta again, and I hope it will go this way, but if the enemy picks like a Renekton or something, you just have to pick a Trundle or another tanky one. So I hope it will go like that with Irelia and Jax, because I just love these champions.
Oh, we hope so too. And then the last question, how do you think it's going with your team now overall? If you look at the standings, what is possible now with the trends that are going on?
So there are still 14 games left. It's just a half time. So we still have a lot of games in front of us where we can turn everything around, like everything can still change. So we'll just try to do as much as we can for that. We always go somehow 1-1 in a weekend. I don't know. First game we lose, second we win. We will try to just change that and just improve everything we can.
Okay, well, thank you very much. Congratulations once
thank
again.
You.
And now we're going to head over to Joe and Quickshot to see how today's games have affected the table.